We don't know whether this is just one extreme isolated example or whether it's more widespread. But what we do know from the report is that it really highlighted some of the commercial conflicts that are arising both within our NHS and within the private sector. And those commercial conflicts are really operating throughout the whole system, as it were, both at the level of hospital trusts in the private sector spire, and especially at the level of the doctors and also at the management. And we can discuss those a bit more throughout.
So if you say that the private sector involved here is a problem, at the moment, when there's an issue like this, the private sector does its own investigation for independent ones, and so the hospital is a viable entity to see the doctor involved. And I think some of the recommendations in this report were to change that and make it independent investigation and the hospital is liable. Do you think that would solve the issue? Is that enough for someone against the private sector?
The evidence in the US is a lot of it. It's when you introduce commercial conflicts, you get behaviour just like the behaviours you've seen with Paterson. And many of the companies that are operating out in NHS have been fined billions of pounds for identical behaviours, over treatment and substandard care. Billions and billions of pounds. So what's happened in the US is that there are enormous fines, but there have been no changes to the system. And one of the problems is now we're seeing within the NHS these commercial conflicts, these private interests of profit motives coming in and actually undermining patient care so that patients are exploited. Really changed